在最近的这一波疫情当中，我们要特别的祈求主耶稣用他宝贵的圣灵与我们每一位弟兄姐妹同在。
In the recent wave of pandemic, we have to especially pray for God's abidance with us.
愿主耶稣的圣灵在我们的心中做主，安慰你，带领你，给你信心，引你走过这一段辛苦的路程。
May God's Holy Spirit dwell in our hearts that it can comfort us and guide us through this journey.
2022年刚开始了第一个礼拜。
The year 2022 has just begun and it has been 1 week.
我们就一起来面对这个挑战。
And we are together facing this challenge.
在这个题目上面，我们只要看见是永远这样的一个字的时候。
And as our topic is today, when we see the word forever,
这个字就穿越了物质，穿越了世界。
This word forever surpasses the world and surpasses material things.
圣经上只要提到是永远的事情，就进入到属灵的国度。
When the Bible uses the word forever, it surpasses the world and enters into the spiritual realm.
已经超过了你跟我，如果还活着，如果还不活着，这样的世界。
And it has surpasses the world where whether we are alive or not.
上个星期，我们一起翻过了石头，来到了吉甲这个地方。
And last week, we discussed about how the rocks were removed and we came to Gilgal.
我们一起来看约书亚记第四章。
Let's turn to the book of Joshua, chapter 4.
约书亚记的第四章。
Joshua, chapter 4.
从第一节开始，我们就看见神是怎么样吩咐他们做这件事。
Starting from verse 1, we could see how the Lord commanded the people.
到了第二节的时候，第四章的第二节，神是这样子吩咐他们的。
And in verse 2, this is how the Lord commanded them.
选十二个人，每个支派选一个人。
Take for yourselves 12 men from the people, one man from every tribe.
然后到了第三节，就说这十二个人呢，是要去取十二块的石头，走过去，带过去，往今夜住宿的地方去。
And starting in verse 3, it talks about how these 12 people should take for themselves 12 stones from here, out of the midst of Jordan, and carry them over with you and leave them in the lodging place where you lodge tonight.
然后我们就看到了第五节。
And then you could see in verse 5,
他们就真的按照这样的事情去做了。
They did according to how they have been commanded.
这边说，每一个人就拿了一块石头扛在肩上，就这样过了。
Each one of them took a stone on their shoulder.
然后这第六节就说，这石头之后要做我们当中的一个记号，一个证据。
And then in verse 6, it says that these stones shall be a sign among you.
然后就说，这些石头是未来子孙们问你它发生了什么事，你要这样这样说。
So in time to come, when your children ask you, what do these stones mean to you? This is how you should answer them.
我们就看到第七节的最后。
And we could see towards the end of verse 7.
约书亚记第四章第七节。
Joshua chapter 4 verse 7.
在最后他说，这些石头就要做永远的纪念。
It says, and these stones shall be a memorial for the children of Israel forever.
我们今天晚上的崇拜一起来学习。这一段的故事带给我们两个想法。
And tonight we will discuss about this story and how it brings two enlightenments to us.
上一次我们聊到了石头代表了几种不一样的意义。
In our last session, we talked about the significance brought by these stones.
今天我们来想一想，这个穿越时空的永远怎么样做纪念。
And today we talk about how these things that surpasses our material world could be used as a memorial.
这些石头，这十二个石头堆起来之后，他说可以永远都记得，永远都有纪念，那是不太可能的。
And as said here that these stones once gathered together shall be a memorial forever, this seems very impossible.
当时间过去的时候，当人换了时候，这些石头可能就倒了。
As time passes by and as the generations pass, these stones might not continue remaining there forever.
但我们非常的相信圣经的记载。
But we clearly remember how it's recorded in the Bible.
说这样做是为了永远的纪念。
Which says that to do it this way is to have a memorial forever.
只有你跟我今天可以明白，这穿越了时间，穿越了历史。
Only you and I here today can understand that this surpasses time and space and history.
它进入了属灵的生命。
It enters into spiritual life.
也进入了你跟我看不见背后的事情。
And it enters into the matters which you and I cannot see with our eyes.
所以这个石头肯定有特别好的意义，来帮助我们当成我们永远的纪念。
So certainly these rocks carry an important significance to us, for us to be a memorial forever.
首先，我们刚才读到的是，他这是从十二个支派选出来的十二个人。
As recorded earlier, these 12 people were chosen from the 12 tribes.
这十二个支派就代表所有以色列人的支派。
And these 12 tribes represent the people of Israelites.
也就是代表了所有的以色列人。
And it also represents all the people of the Israelites.
这十二个人要一起做这件事。
And these 12 people were to do this matter together.
这十二个人集合成一个，共同完成同一件事情。
And these 12 people gathered to carry out one single matter.
如果我们当成他就是去抬石头的十二个人，可能就没有什么稀奇的。
So, if it's not these 12 people who are carrying the rocks, then it's nothing to be surprised about.
但是如果我们想到这个人的集合，就跟今天的教会是有关系的。
But if we were to relate the gathering of these 12 people to our churches today,
我们一起来参考圣经。以弗所书第一章。
Let's turn to Ephesians chapter 1.
以弗所书第一章第22节、23节。
Ephesians chapter 1 verses 22 and 23.
以弗所书第一章第22节。
Ephesians chapter 1 verse 22.
使耶稣基督作为教会的头。
And he put all things under his feet and gave him to be head of over all things to the church.
那么到23节就说教会就是耶稣基督的身体。
Verse 23, which is his body.
所以告诉了我们，这是一个很特别的一件事情，就是教会原来是耶稣的身体。
So it tells us something very unique here that the church, that Christ is the head of the church.
也就是我们今天有许许多多新的朋友不断地加入这个群体的时候。
That today when we have new friends joining our congregation,
我们每个人的想法都不一样。
Everyone has a different set of mindset.
我们来参加的是一场聚会。
What we're attending is a service.
我们去的是一间教会。
And we go to one church.
所以我们常常问说，你明天要去教会吗？
That is why we often ask each other, will you be attending church tomorrow?
我们想象的教会就是这个地方。
So the church that we could think of is this place.
所以就是我去或是我不去。
This is where I choose to go or not to go.
那从这边来看，教会是耶稣的身体。
But from here, we could see that the church is the body of Christ.
换一句话说是，明天你要去耶稣的身体吗？
In other words, are you going to Jesus' body tomorrow?
如果我们常常这样子问，就常常这样提醒了自己。
If we keep asking ourselves this, then we keep reminding ourselves the same matter.
可能就不太会想说，我才不去呢，我没空。
Maybe then we would not again refuse to go.
好了。这个是耶稣的身体，我们再来看一段圣经，我们熟悉的《哥林多前书》的十二章。
So now let's refer to 1 Corinthians chapter 12.
哥林多前书的十二章十三节。
First Corinthians chapter 12 verse 13.
所以我们从这边又看到了，他就说，我们不论是什么什么什么样的人，我们都从一位圣灵受了洗。
So here it says that no matter what kind of people we are all being baptized into one body.
然后就成了一个身体了。
And we became one body.
然后我们都饮于同一个圣灵。
And we are made to drink in one spirit.
就现在如果我们有三十个人坐在这儿。
So if there's 30 of us sitting here today.
我们其实就已经是在教会里面，我们就叫做教会。
So in other words, we are one church.
我们就是一个集合体。
We're a congregation.
我们就是那十二个人。
We're the 12 tribes.
我们就是一起在做同一件的事情。
Together, we're carrying out the same matter.
我们来看十四节。
Let's refer to verse 14.
哥林多前书十二章十四节。
First Corinthians chapter 12, verse 14.
他说这个身体，也就是这个教会，它不是一个肢体，它是许许多多的肢体。
For in fact, the body is not one member, but many.
所以是一群人集合在一起，成为了你今天所说的教会。
It's a congregation of a group of people that forms the church that we understand today.
那这个字要演变来，从历史上你可以去搜寻许多的资料。
So we can do some research through the times regarding this word.
其实最早期就是一群被召的人。
So in the very beginning, it was a group of people who have been called.
就是那一群人集合在一起，一聚集在一起，这个就叫教会。
So when a group of people gather together, that is called church.
所以我们再看回刚才我们读到的，这十二个人去到约旦河中，搬十二个石头上来，照着神的话去做。
So we could see that earlier, these 12 people out of the 12 tribes carried the stones according to the commandments of God.
他们就是在做一个教会的动作。
So they were carrying out this action that is church.
这个群体就集合在一起了。
So this congregation has gathered together.
最重要的这个概念就是在一起。
So the main concept is to be together.
我们虽然坐的不同的排，不同一排一排的椅子。
Even though we are seated at different rows.
可是我们是在一起。
But we are together.
我们一在一起就成为了教会。
Once we are together, we form a church.
我们就成为那十二个人。
We form these 12 people.
我们人跟人之间就有了关系。
And between man and man, we have this relationship.
我们不再是你，也不再是我。
We're no longer you and I.
我们是连结在一个圣灵，一个身体的里面。
We're joined in one spirit and in one body.
所以我们不再是我的事情与你无关。
So we're no longer your matter has nothing to do with me.
因为我们要一起来搬十二个石头。
Because together we want to move these 12 stones.
那做这件事情会得到永远的纪念。
And to carry out this matter,There will be a memorial forever.
因为我们在社会上很久的这个时间，我们受了教育，我们会有自己的个性，自己的想法。
And because we have dwelt in the society for a long time, and through education and influence of the society, we have our different mindset and our different thinking.
我们也几乎不可能离开社会。
And it is impossible for us to depart from the world.
因为这不是耶稣的教训。
Because this is not the teaching of God.
耶稣要我们进入到世界里面。救每一个人。
Jesus wants us to enter into the society and save everyone.
所以我们会遇到很多的挑战，因为我们跟人只要一有关系就有挑战。
Therefore, we will be faced with many challenges because once we encounter with other people, there will be challenges.
可是我们是被召的一群人。
So we are a group of people who have been called.
所以我们只要一聚在一起做同一件事情的时候，你知，那就是得到神永远的纪念。
So once we are gathered together to carry out one matter, one single matter, that is when we will be remembered by God.
不能小看这件事。
Let us not look down upon this.
所以为什么我们的学生去参加一个星期的讲习还是灵恩会的时候，他们会有一种很热烈的感觉。
This is why our students are greatly moved when they attend this one-week student spiritual convocation.
因为他们被神纪念。
Because they have been remembered by God.
当神纪念的时候，神的恩惠、神的力量就在那个当中。
When God remembers you, His grace will be among you.
所以我们不小看我们每次聚在一起的这样的事情的时候，我们其实已经把我们的心呈现在神的面前，得到他的纪念。
So when we are gathered together, this is when we present ourselves to be remembered by God.
所以我们第一个想到是，这十二个人代表了全体的人。
So the first thing that we know is these 12 men from 12 different tribes represent the people.
他们已经不是一个一个的人。
They're no longer separate identity individuals.
他们在神的面前已经是一个群体，一个教会。
Before God, they're a congregation and they're a church.
只是那时候还没有用这个名词来形容他们。
But at that time, that this noun were not used to describe them.
让我们刚才读的圣经，我们再回来看约书亚记的第四章。
Now let us turn back to Joshua chapter 4,
第七节
verse 7.
他在第六节的时候呢，就说到说，你以后要怎么怎么对后来的人讲说这个故事。
So in verse 6, it talks about how you want to tell the story to your children in time to come.
所以到了第七节，你就看到他说，你们要这样说，连说法都告诉他们，好像写了剧本一样。
And in verse 7, it even tells them how they should answer the children. It's likened to a script written prepared for them.
他说，因为约旦河 在这个地方就断了，因为神进来了，就在这个地方断了，然后就过河，约柜过河的时候，这个水就这样停了。
Because, the waters of Jordan were cut off before the Ark of Covenant, and when it crossed the river Jordan, the waters of Jordan were cut off.
他说这些话要讲给谁听啊？
So who should we tell these words to?
他说讲给你日后的子孙听。
So these words were to be told to the children.
那我们就想说，哦，那就是讲给你孩子听吧。
So we could imagine that these words were to be told to our children.
到了新约的时候，他带给我们第二个观念。
But in the New Testament, it brought us another concept.
我们来看哥林多前书的第四章。
Let's turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 4.
保罗对这些旧约的故事，特别能够把它诠释成今天我们能够接触以及明白的道理。
Paul related these stories from the Old Testament to what we could understand in our daily lives.
哥林多前书的第四章第十五节。
First Corinthians chapter 4 verse 15.
他说我们今天很多人都在学习基督。
It says today many of us are learning about Christ.
但是大部分的人喜欢当老师。
But majority of us would like to be instructors.
但真正想要当父亲的人却不多。
But there are not many who wants to be fathers.
因为可能当父亲的要付出很多的代价。
Because being fathers, there are a lot of sacrifices to be made.
可能要被拒绝。
You might be rejected.
你们有被拒绝过吗？被孩子拒绝过吗？
Have you ever been rejected by your children?
就是你讲什么话，你孩子根本不理你。
That is to say that your children ignores whatever you say.
那个当父母的心就会知道那是什么感觉。
So parents would understand how it feels to be ignored.
所以保罗就能够体会，就写说，当父母亲的不多啊。
That is why Paul says that not many of you want to be fathers.
就父母亲有时候要忍。
Sometimes parents have to tolerate.
那保罗就把他自己形容是这样的。
So Paul described himself as being so.
他对了这些哥林多的信徒说，我在基督里用福音生了你们。
So through to the church of Corinth, he told them that I gave birth to you through gospel.
这是一个很特别的观念。
This is a very new concept.
也就是说，今天所有我们进来的教会的弟兄姐妹们。
That is to say that every one of us who enters into the church today.
当我们开始常常听到道理说，哎，我们要去带我们的朋友，要去传福音的时候。
When we hear that we need to bring our friends and preach the gospel.
你可知那有多难吗？
Do you know how hard is that?
然后你带来一个的时候。
And when you bring one to seeker.
整个教会会为这个而高兴。
The entire church will rejoice for this person.
那这就是我们生的儿女。
Because this is the child that we have give birth to.
所以福音生的儿女就是新来的人。
So, children who have been born of gospel are the true believers.
福音当我们传给他之后，
when we preach the gospel to them,
他从世界回头了，进入到神的国度里面。
They return from the world and enter into the heavenly kingdom of God.
然后你跟我慢慢的引导他，带领他，跟他做朋友。
And you and I will gradually guide this person. And be friends with them.
慢慢的，他就坐在我们当中。
And slowly, gradually, they would be seated among us.
他就变成了一个集体、团体一的这个概念。
And it will form part of the congregation.
所以这两件事情是有关系的。
So these two matters are related.
十二个人代表了一个群体。
So these 12 men represent a congregation.
那么后来的子孙，除了我们自己生的孩子之外，我们在福音上所生的孩子也都是在这个群体的当中。
And the children, besides the children, besides our own children, the newer believers are also, part of the children.
所以我们对于慕道的朋友
，So towards truth seekers，
我们对于新受洗的朋友
，Towards newly baptized members，
我们对于在艰难中软弱的弟兄姐妹
，towards our brothers and sisters who are in affliction，
我们都要像保罗这样的心，去像父亲一样忍着被拒绝，然后靠近他们。
We have to be like Paul, to be like a father, to endure being rejected, to go near to them.
很少看到父母亲因为被孩子拒绝以后，父母亲就 叫他滚出去，再也不让他吃饭了。
It's very rare that we deny our children of food when we have been ignored by them.
两三天之后，还要小心翼翼的，不敢提前天发生的事情。
Two or three days later, we have to even be careful not to bring up what happened 2 days ago.
那个就是父母的心肠。
And these are the hearts of parents.
所以他说，这样的福音生的孩子就在我们的当中。
So here it says that, these people born of gospel are among us.
所以我们刚才一起学习了两个新的眼光。
So there are two concepts that we've learned.
我们学习到十二个人代表了群体集合在一起的一在一起。
First is these 12 men represent the congregation, one congregation.
我们也学习到要把这样的带领神带领出埃及过约旦河到今天的这个故事讲给后来的人听。
The second thing that we learn is to tell these stories about the Israelites passing the River Jordan to our future generation.
神从埃及带他们出来这件事情就是福音。
It is a gospel on its own in this matter where God brought the Israelites out of Egypt.
他们怎么样进入到迦南，进入到神的国度应许的地方。
How did they enter into the land of Canaan? And how did they enter into the promised land of God?
他说这两个东西我们今天只谈两个，这两个就是一个永远的纪念。
These two matters. Today we will only look at these two matters and they are memorial forever.
我们就想那就纪念吧，反正读一读我也纪念了，我就感恩，觉得神好伟大哦。
So we will take this lightly thinking that if we need to remember this forever, then we'll just do that.
现在我们投入到当中的时候，
But when we are indulged in this concept,
你跟我就是那十二个人。
You and I are part of these 12 tribes.
你跟我现在就在扛石头在肩上。
You and I are carrying these stones on the streets.
想象一下，我们就要扛石头。
Imagine that you and I need to carry these stones.
走过约旦河。
To pass by River Jordan.
抬到基甲这个地方。
To cross River Jordan.
然后要放下来。
To the land of Gilgal, and then to place these stones.
然后十二个人要把石头叠上去。
And these 12 people need to stack up these 12 stones.
然后心中要记得一件事。
And in their hearts, they need to remember this.
就是等一下还是将来，有人问起我为什么在这里有石头的时候，我要这样这样这样说。
That in the future, when asked about these stones, this is how I would answer.
然后这件事情是永远的纪念。
And this matter is a memorial forever.
所以我们今天来想，我们怎么样把这个纪念，让它每一天都发生在我们的生活里面。
So now let us ponder how can we let this memorial forever to happen in our daily lives every single day.
不然的话，它真的是一个历史故事。
If not, it would just be a history that we learn.
不然的话，你真的只是一个真耶稣教会的信徒。
If not, you will only be a member of True Jesus Church.
那不然的话，你真的就是只是自己在家感谢神。
If not, you would only be thanking God at home yourself.
但这整个路程有它特别的意义。
But this entire journey has its own significance.
第一是要扛石头。
Number one, to carry these stones.
是全部的人要扛石头。
That every single person needs to carry this stone.
我不太想象说，那个时候他们在选石头的时候，会不会像我这样？
So sometimes I try to think if when they were choosing these stones, would they be like me?
因为我那个什么骨头不好嘛，就是脚没有什么力气。
Because my legs are weak and my bones are weak.
所以我去选的时候，我可能会选那个蛮小颗的。
So when I'm choosing the stones, I might choose the smaller one.
对，那因为可是圣经说他们是扛着，扛在肩上。
And because the Bible says that these men carry the stones.
肯定是重量，有重量的。
Of course, it carries some weight.
所以我们来想，在我们今天的生活中，这 这个帮助了我们什么事情，想到什么事情。
So let us reflect on our daily lives on how this matter applies to us.
当我们一起扛石头的时候
When we are carrying the stones,
我们一起哦，做一件事情哦。
Together we'll do this.
同样的事情。
We'll do the same thing.
这个就进入到集体。
This will enter into the congregation.
那一进入到集体就成为了教会。
When it enters into the congregation, it becomes part of the church.
然后这个教会要发出的声音就有它。
And this voice that will be manifested by the church will include that person.
对，它要发出的声音是固定的。
So this voice that is manifested is fixed.
我们来看一段圣，我们来看一段圣经，希伯来书。
Let's turn to the book of Hebrews.
第二章。
Chapter 2,
希伯来书第二章第十二节。
Hebrews chapter 2, verse 12.
希伯来书第二章第十二节。
Hebrews chapter 2, verse 12.
我们有在这一段圣经看到一个字叫做在集体的会中一起，有没有看到？
Yes. Okay, so here we could see the words in the midst of the assembly.
对，他说在这个当中，就是他把这个教会放进来了，这就是他原来的字，就是一个集体的东西。他说我要将你的名，这段圣经是我要将你的名传给我的弟兄。
So it says here, I will declare your name to my brethren. In the midst of assembly, I will sing praise to you.
对，他直接念完了。那我们就知道说在这一段圣经里面，他给了我们一个特别的字，就是集合的工作是在做一个颂扬的事情。
So from this Bible verse we know that the work of the word assembly means to declare and praise, give praise.
然后他跟旧约的诗篇是同一段圣经，我们来看诗篇22篇22节。
Now let's refer to Psalms chapter 22, verse 2.
它是同样的一段圣经。
It's the same Bible passage.
那但是它因为用的语言不一样。
But because the language used is different.
所以其实从很早以前的时候就已经有了集体，也就是教会的这个字出现。
So from very early on, the word congregation and assembly has already been used.
所以你可以看到说，其实在旧约已经有这个集合的概念，这就是神一直以来的计划。
So we could see that even already in the Old Testament, the word assembly was already appeared, and that was the plan of God.
所以它真的不是我们想象中，说你明天要不要去教会这件事情这么简单。
So it's not as simple as asking each other, do we want to go to church tomorrow?
对，因为它不是一个地点了。
Because it's no longer a venue.
它是一个集合的。这个一集合在这边，这个就在神的里面。
Because it's an assembly where once we assemble, we're in God.
那在抬石头就是这个概念。
So the carrying the stones is the same concept.
它是互相的。
It's mutual.
它不会是每个人的肌肉都很大的。
It's not that everyone is very well built in their muscles.
有人是比较抬不动的。
Some people can carry less heavy.
它必须跟人跟人。有关系。
So it's related to man and man.
所以只要一讲到教会的时候，其实它是跟人跟人的关系，是就是这个意思。
So when we talk about the church, it revolves around the relationship between man and man.
所以我们一进到教会或是一想到教会的时候，其实要想到的是人。
So when we think of the church, we should think about the people.
我们要对人有兴趣啊，弟兄姐妹。
We need to be interested in the people.
我们如果只对事情有兴趣的时候，是不够的。
If we're only interested in matters, then it's not enough.
老师来教书就是一个事情。
Teachers teaching students, it's a matter.
所以保罗说，当老师的人很多。
That is why Paul said there are many people who want to be instructors.
可是要用福音生下你们的这个父母不多啊。
And those who are willing to begot children out of gospel to be fathers, they're not many.
我们一抬石头要过约旦河。我们就要想到，我跟你是有关系的。
When we want to carry these stones to cross River Jordan, we have to remember that you and I, we are related.
我不可能只有我自己抬过去，剩下的九个石头掉在路上。
We cannot just cross River Jordan carrying one stone and let the rest just drop fall on the ground.
我不知道他们当时是不是还要回头看一下你 OK 吗？你要不要回来帮一下你？
I'm not sure at that time did they have to turn around to make sure that the others are carrying the stones well.
这样的动作就发生了关系。
So these actions, cause relationships.
这样的动作就让神喜悦。
These actions gain favor in God's eyes.
这样的动作就得到纪念。
These actions are to be remembered.
这样的动作叠起来的石头会穿越时空的历史到属灵的国度。
These actions of stacking the stones surpasses, time and the material world and enters into the spiritual realm.
所以我们只要一想到教会，我们就要想到弟兄姐妹。
So when we think about the church, we have to think about the church brothers and sisters.
我们正在做同一件事情。
We're doing the same thing.
我们正在扛石头。
We are all carrying stones.
我们正在建造石头堆上去。
We are all building and stacking up these stones.
我们一边做这个动作的时候，一边颂扬神。
And as we are carrying out this matter together, we are also praising the Lord.
这就是圣经的教训。
This is the teaching from the Bible.
它鼓励了我们的方向。
It encouraged us and gave us a direction.
我们是要一起扛石头的。
Together we want to carry the stones.
我们要彼此照顾的。
We want to take care of each other.
可是每一次扛石头的时候，我们都要从我们的心中嘴里发出赞美的声音。
But each time we carry these stones, we have to praise the Lord from our hearts.
我们讲我们自己的见证。感谢的事情。
When we give thanks and bear testimonies,
我们一坐下来就想到上个星期有什么东西可以分享的。
When we sit down, we think about what we could share from the past week.
这个就是永远的纪念了。
This is a memorial forever.
不要小看每个礼拜五、每个礼拜六来到这边跟人讲的每一句话。
Let us not look down on what we share with brothers and sisters every Friday and Saturday.
你知道穿越了时空进入到属灵的国度吗？
You know, it passes time and space and enters into the spiritual realm.
这个是我们一起的学习。
This is what we should learn together.
这个是非常正面的。
This is very positive.
我们往这个正面的方向走的时候，我们就得蒙神的纪念。
When we walk towards this positive light, then we will be remembered by God.
这个在新的一年的开始，我们就提醒了自己。
In this new beginning, new year, we want to remind ourselves.
我们就问自己，这很难吗？
Let us ask ourselves, is this very hard to do?
我那一次问一个人，他说真的很难啊。
That day I asked someone, and he said it's really very hard to do.
我真的也是学到，我们都好可爱哦。
So I also learned that we are so adorable.
对，说，你看那个，我跟他没话讲。
So sometimes we will say that, that person, I don't have much to talk to him about.
你看那个。
You look at that person.
整天苦瓜脸。
His face looks so bitter.
英文有苦瓜脸吗？
对，
苦瓜。然后就说，我本来嘻嘻，我本来快快乐乐来，看到那个苦瓜脸，我回家也苦瓜。
I originally I'm so happy, but once I see the bitter God face of this person, I became very sad.
然后还有人选位置哦。
And some people even choose where they want to sit.
就是前面那几个他不喜欢。
If they don't like those seated in the front rows.
一进来就一直默祷哎。
These few people came in and they started saying silent prayer.
不是，是我一直默祷。
I kept saying silent prayer once I enter.
就是希望他不要来。
Hoping that that person will not come.
因为他每次要坐到我的前面，我真的头晕。
Because it's always seated in front of me, and that gives me a headache.
所以你就看到，哎，好像也不容易哦。
So it is actually not easy to do.
还没有扛石头哎。
This is even before we
就很想把石头丢到他脸上去。
And already we feel like throwing the stones at their face.
对，所以我们最后就变成就是我跟他比较好，我跟他比较不好。
So at the end, we started forming cliques and be closer to some church members, but not the others.
2022年开始了。
Starting in year 2022,
我们一起扛石头。
Let us carry these stones together.
正面的往前走。
To walk forward positively.
做主耶稣喜欢我们的事。
To do the matters that is pleasing to God.
告诉自己，这很难吗？
To ask ourselves, is this very hard to do?
我只要一进到教会，一想到教会，我就要跟人有关系。
That when we enter into the church, when we think about church, it has to relate to people.
因为我们是一合在一起的一。
Because we are one.
然后我们在这里面还会再看见一些新的朋友。
And then when we come here, we will meet with new friends.
所以我们的每天生活还要想到他们啊。
So in our daily lives, we ought to think about all these new friends.
哦, 怎么样把福音, 怎么样慢慢地生下他们, 让他们明白。
How do we slowly begot them through gospel so that they could understand?
所以亲爱的弟兄姐妹, 你对慕道者也要发生兴趣。
So brothers and sisters, you also need to have interest towards these truth seekers.
因为这是耶稣升天之前所讲的话。
Because this is what God, this is what Jesus told us before he ascended into heaven.
他叫我们要传福音。
That we have to preach the gospel.
那我们传福音一定会碰到人，我们不会跟墙讲话。
Because when we're preaching the gospel, we're facing people, but not the wall.
哎，有了，现在说是跟电脑讲。
Now, apparently, we could talk to the computer.
对，自己录嘛。
That we could record. Our voices.
对，自己可以录一段你要来信耶稣的讲话，可以。
We could record an audio note to preach the gospel.
所以我们传福音是主耶稣留给我们的使命。
So, to preach the gospel is a mission by Jesus.
那我们就要对新朋友也是人哦，我们对慕道者要有兴趣。
So we need to have interest towards these truth seekers.
起码知道他们的名字。
At least know their names.
起码知道他们来多久了。
At least know how long they've been attending services.
才不会主耶稣有时候会真的考试我们，真的就把我们放在那个门口，这样一碰到我们还说，哎，你谁啊？
So that when God is giving us a test, we will not be placed at the door.